a passion and an audacious bedroom fortress, trapped inside a fever dream of femininity. The gunstringer steeled himself for the wild-eyed body onslaught to come. Madam was a quarrelsome, temperish woman who fought the passage of time and the toll of gravity like a lassoed wildcat. She wore enough face paint to send half the Comanches in Texas on the warpath and had a top shelf you could lay a Stetson on. But no amount of foppery could conceal her deceitful core, and the gunstringer made ready to address her true self with the language of gunpowder and steel.
Everybody.
Take the hand of fate to knock it free. the gang first formed, they took on a young samurai on the condition that he add firearms to his bladed arsenal. And thus did the Beardmaster join in their mission of monetary reallocation. His subsequent betrayal of the Gunstringer, however, was not an issue that would be so easily adjudicated. Targets lined up. It was time to fire. Gunstringer came down, but felt nothing but air beneath him. He leapt nimble-like to the other side, like a goat. He stumbled forward, dazed by the collision. An eye for an eye, like in the olden times. There was justice to be done that day, and he was the man for it. The boulders came at him faster than green grass through goose. A half dozen shots lit up the air. Made tossing lead fun, but the Gunstringer had to keep his eye on the prize. He reached the other side without difficulty. Really? impact rocked the Gunstringer, but his will was untarnished. Gunstringer breathed in sharply as he was gored to the bone.